The USS Chafee sailed near islands claimed by China in the South China Sea. The officials, speaking on condition of anonymity, said the USS Chafee carried out normal maneuvering operations that challenged excessive maritime claims near the Paracel Islands, among a string of islets, reefs, and shoals over which China has territorial disputes with its neighbors. It was the fourth freedom of navigation operation during Trump's presidency. China's sweeping claims of sovereignty over the sea have annoyed competing claimants, Malaysia, Vietnam, Brunei, Taiwan, Indonesia, and the Philippines. The United States, Japan, Australia, and India favor freedom of navigation as it's a very important sea route with $5 trillion in trade, half of global merchant shipping, and half of the world's oil shipment pass through it. The seas also has allegedly 11 billion barrels of untapped oil and 190 trillion cubic feet of natural gas. This operation is the latest attempt to counter what Washington sees as Beijing's efforts to limit freedom of navigation in the strategic waters. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the capabilities of the USS Chafee in 5 points and understands why China should fear it. Let's get started.
Number 5.
The USS Chafee, DDG-90, is an Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyer in the United States Navy. Arleigh Burke-class warships were designed as multi-mission destroyers capable of anti-aircraft warfare, AAW, anti-submarine warfare, ASW, and anti-surface warfare, ASUW. USS Chafee was laid down by the Bath Ironworks at Bath in Maine on the 12th of April 2001, launched on the 2nd of November 2002, and commissioned on the 18th of October 2003. Chafee is an active unit of the Pacific Fleet and operates out of Pearl Harbor, Hawaii.
Number 4.
USS Chafee, being an Arleigh Burke-class destroyer, is among the largest destroyers in the world. It has an average length of 505 feet and displacement of about 9,200 tons. It's powered by four General Electric LM2530 gas turbines with two shafts, powering 100,000 total shaft horsepower, 75 megawatts. It has a speed of 30 plus knots, that's more than 55 kilometers per hour, and a range of 4,400 nautical miles, or 8,100 kilometers.
Number 3.
The Arleigh Burke class of guided missile destroyers is the United States Navy's first class of destroyer built around the AEGIS combat system. The AEGIS Ballistic Missile Defense System is a United States DOD, Department of Defense, Missile Defense Agency program developed to provide missile defense against short to intermediate range ballistic missiles. AEGIS BMD is designed to intercept ballistic missiles post-boost phase and prior to reentry. It enables the USS Chafee to shoot down enemy ballistic missiles by expanding the AEGIS combat system with the addition of the AN/SPY-1 radar and standard missile technologies. AEGIS BMD-equipped vessels can transmit their target detection information to other systems and, if needed, engage potential threats using either SM-2 or SM-3 missiles.
Number 2.
The heart of the AEGIS systems on board the USS Chafee is an advanced automatic detect and track multifunctional phased array radar, the AN/SPY-1. The high-powered 4-megawatt radar is able to perform search, track, and missile guidance functions simultaneously with a capability of over 100 targets. A conventional mechanically rotating radar sees a target when the radar beam strikes that target once during each 360-degree rotation of the antenna. A separate tracking radar is then required to engage each target. By contrast, the computer-controlled AN/SPY-1A phased array radar of the AEGIS system brings these functions together within one system. The phased array can concentrate energy where it's needed. The operator can boost the range and resolution in a particular direction without blinding the ship to threats from another side. The four fixed arrays of SPY send out beams of electromagnetic energy in all directions simultaneously, continuously providing a search and tracking capability for hundreds of targets at the same time. This radar is expected to track enemy aircrafts from as far as 300 kilometers.
Number 1.
USS Chafee is one of the most heavily armed destroyers in the world. It's designed to be a multi-weapons platform. It has 96-cell Mark 41 VLS, which can be configured with the combination of the following weapons based on mission. 1. Tomahawk cruise missile for land attack. It's a subsonic missile with a range of 2,500 kilometers. 2. RIM-162 Evolved Sea Sparrow Medium Range SAM for air defense. It has a speed of Mach 4 and a range of 50 kilometers. 3. RIM-66 Standard Missile SM-2 Missile for AEGIS Ballistic Missile Defense. It has a speed of Mach 3.5 and a range of 150 kilometers. It also has two Mark 141 Harpoon Missile Launcher for anti-ship roll. It's a subsonic missile with a range of 125 kilometers. Two Mark 32 triple torpedo tubes are present, launching Mark 46 or Mark 50 torpedoes, which have a speed in excess of 70 kilometers per hour and a range of 15 kilometers. Two Sikorsky MH-60R helicopters are also present for anti-submarine warfare. It carries a complex system of sensors, including a towed magnetic anomaly detector, and air-launched sonobuoys, enabling it to detect enemy submarines at long ranges. This has visibly irked China. Beijing officials issued a public complaint on Wednesday over this freedom of navigation operation by the USS Chafee. Ministry of Foreign Affairs spokesperson Hua Chunying said during a press briefing, "The transit of USS Chafee violated Chinese territorial sovereignty by entering a claimed territorial sea without prior notification." She said, "On October 10th, the missile destroyer USS Chafee entered China's territorial sea off the Jisha Paracel Islands to carry out a so-called freedom of navigation operation without China's approval. The Chinese side immediately sent naval ships and fighter planes to identify and verify the U.S. warship according to law and warn and expel it." She added, "The relevant behavior of the U.S. warship has violated the Chinese law and relevant international law, severely undermined China's sovereignty and security interests, put in jeopardy the life, safety of the frontline personnel from both sides. China is firmly opposed to this and has lodged serious representation with the U.S. side. It remains to be seen how this confrontation pans out in coming days." Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.